मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द फोर्स चैप्टर, कॉन्टैक्ट एंड नॉन कॉन्टैक्ट फोर्स और द टाइप्स ऑफ फोर्सेस. लेट्स सी द आंसर्स ऑफ स्टॉप एंड रिफ्लेक्ट. सो स्ट्रेचिंग एन इलास्टिक कॉर्ड, सो हियर फोर्स चेंजेस द शेप ऑफ द ऑब्जेक्ट, और यू हैव टू राइट हियर द इलास्टिक कॉर्ड. सी हियर इन केस ऑफ सेकेंड वन, रोइंग अ बोट विथ मोर फोर्स, सो द बोट विल मूव फास्टर, यू हैव टू राइट. देन स्टॉपिंग अ रोलिंग स्टोन विथ अ स्टिक, सो स्टोन स्टॉप्स मूविंग. देन hitting a ping pong ball with a racket, so the ball moves faster, and returning the ball by hitting with a racket in a game of lawn tennis, so you have to write the ball moves back or changes the direction of motion. Now let's see the types of forces. So before discussing this type of forces, let me revise what you have learned in 5th standard. You have learned that there are various types of forces: muscular force, gravitational force, electrostatic force, mechanical force, magnetic force and frictional force. Like this you have, see here in these two cases what happens here. Here see the force is applied by the two boys acts simultaneously on the box. So in this case the force acting on an object is called resultant force. Okay, here also the force will be called as resultant force or an unbalanced force as written in your book. So see, when two force applied on the object in the same direction, then what will happen? Then the magnitude or the resultant force will be the sum of the both forces applied. Right, so in that see here, if we will take the force applied by one first boy is 80 newton and by the second boy is 60, then the resultant force which will be acting on this box particular, this box will be the see suppose there is a box and two persons are pushing the box from the opposite direction, then what will happen? If the box doesn't move, then what we can conclude? We can conclude that the forces exerted by the two persons from both sides or which are acting on the object are equal. So such force will result in no movement. So that is called balanced force. Okay, what kind of force? Balanced force. But in case there is a movement wherever more forces apply it, and there is a movement is there, that means suppose first boy applies more force than the second boy, then the box will move in the direction where? Yes, you are absolutely right. Wherever the more force or the direction where the first boy wants the box to move. So such forces which results in movement and they act on the object, then the object will move in the direction where more force is there, so that is called unbalanced force. Where you will see the example in day-to-day life of unbalanced force? Yes, you are absolutely right. Whenever we are moving or we are pulling something or pushing something, then that is unbalanced force. So the first examples where the boys were pushing the box given in shown in the picture, there unbalanced force. Okay, so again, force is a push or pull. So whenever we are pushing something, then what will happen? We are applying force, we are touching that object directly, or when we are pulling something with the help of a rope or something, then what happens? The rope is in our contact of our hand and the rope is in contact of the object, so there is a direct contact. So in terms of pushing also, when we are pushing a box or we are pulling something from the well, suppose we are pulling the bucket from the well, then what will happen? There is a direct contact. So those are called contact force, which acts when two objects are in physical contact with each other. Okay, so like muscular force, frictional force, the contact force is there. Okay. Then, if you see a magnet, then what happens? Magnet attracts an iron nail and you cannot see the force applied by the magnet directly. Or when anything falls, suppose an apple or a guava falls to the ground, then you cannot see the gravitational force, no? So such forces are called non-contact force, that acts between two objects that are not in direct or actual contact. So the examples are magnetic force, gravitational force and electrostatic force. I hope you have understood this much. Some of the force what the two boys are applying, so this will be 140 Newton. So, but in the second case, two boys are what they are pushing the box in the opposite direction. Then what will be the resulting force and in which direction the box will move? So here what will happen, the boy which who will put more force, so the force will act on the direction where he wants it to move. So here the first boy is putting a force of 80 Newton, another is 60 Newton. So the resulting force will be 80 minus 60, that is 20 Newton. So here what will happen, the resultant force will act on the direction of this boy because he is putting on more force. Okay, so this unbalanced force depends upon, you know, the interaction of the, okay, so the resultant force, the boy will be 20 Newton, so the box will be moving in the direction where this boy wants. Now depending upon the physical interaction where the two bodies, where we say interact with each other directly or indirectly for force to be effective, then what will happen? If there is a direct contact, then the force will be contact forces, and if there is indirect contact, then that is the non-contact forces. So in these two categories, the force is basically categorized into. To make the idea more clear, here you can see what happens here. There is a direct contact. The force is applied on the box directly by the boy. So there is contact. So this kind of force or the muscular force is a contact force. Understood? See here, the people are pulling a rope. Or a boy is lifting a heavy box, or a person walking on the road, or a horse or a bullock is pulling a cart. All these examples are the examples of muscular force. Then you see the wind which pushes the sailboat or a windmill here, the mechanical force, and now see the force which is applied on the object, okay, to change its state, that is called applied force. And when you support the force extended on a body that is in contact with another stable body, like see the scale, I am putting it on the book, then what will happen? The book will exert an upward force on the glass to support its weight. Okay, so this is called normal force. When you play the game of a tug of war, then what happens? It is stretched. Or when you pull a cart with rope, then what happens? The rope is stretched and the cart moves. So that is the tension. That is called tension. Okay. Then there is muscular force. That means the force which we exert or which we use for our day-to-day work, That means the force exerted by the muscles of our body is called muscular force. Then there is a collision force. When two bodies collide with each other, then that is the collision force. And when a ball rolling on the floor stops moving, then there is a force that acts on the opposite direction of the motion of the moving ball, that is called force of friction. Because of the force of friction, the soles of our shoes also, what happens? That gradually withers away. Okay? Or the wear and tear happens to the soles of our shoes or the tires of the car. Okay, or moving parts of the machine, that is due to friction. Then there is one more force called mechanical force. That means the force produced by the machine. Okay, the non-contact forces, all these forces are up to mechanical force or contact forces. Now let's see the non-contacting force. So, I have already told you about the force of the magnet. So, the magnetic force is an example of a non-contact force. That means the force of attraction exerted by the magnet on the magnetic substances is called magnetic force. Another force is electrostatic force. So, what happens when you rub a dry plastic comb or a scale to your dry hair, which is without oil, then what happens? The scale becomes charged. So the force exerted by the charged body on another charged or uncharged body is called electrostatic force. They can either attract each other or repel each other. See here, the comb is attracting the dry piece of paper because of electrostatic force. Then there is a gravitational force. You know, when you throw a ball from a height or the apple falls to the ground, that is due to the force or attractive pull of the earth, that is called gravitational force or gravity. Okay, up to this, there is the syllabus of the quarterly exam. We'll read about the friction in our next video. That will be the concluding part of the chapter, but it is not in the syllabus of the quarterly exam. Okay, I hope you have understood. Now you will have to do some questions as the classwork. Explain the following terms: contact forces, electrostatic force, normal force, friction and muscular force. Okay, and you have to write the answer in one word from page number 59 as your homework. So I hope you have understood.